In this section, we'll learn about total allowable error and how it can be calculated for a test. Total error TE is the overall error in a single test result due to the imprecision and bias of the measurement system. The total error formula consists of three components: z-score, imprecision, bias. We'll examine each of these components in more detail. The z-score is the desired probability of inclusion inside the targeted limits. Dr. Callum Fraser, a leading expert in the field of biological variation and its application in the clinical diagnostic laboratory. Dr. Callum Fraser provided the following example of probabilities and z-scores in his text, Biological Variation, From Principles to Practice. Using this example, we can see that if we apply a z-score of 2.33 in the equation for TE, then we desire to include 99% of the values within our target limits. This is a probability of p less than 0.01. The second component is imprecision. Imprecision is expressed as the coefficient of variation, CV%. To calculate for CV%, divide the laboratory's standard deviation by the laboratory's mean, and then convert the result into a percent by multiplying by 100. A laboratory can perform the calculation to obtain the CV%, or alternatively use one of the following sources to obtain the information: the Laboratory Information System (LIS), third-party QC software, interlaboratory reports, external quality assessment reports. The last component of the equation is bias. The calculation for bias requires two pieces of information: lab mean, consensus group mean. The laboratory mean can be obtained from the LIS or third-party QC software. The consensus group mean can be obtained from interlaboratory or EQAS reports. For example, in the LIS, we determine that our laboratory mean for a test is 100. And using an interlaboratory report, we find that the consensus group mean for that same test is 105. We can use these values to calculate a bias percent of -4.8%. When we use bias in the equation to calculate for TE, we only use absolute values. So any signs, negative or positive, are dropped. Now we'll put the components together and calculate the TE for a test. If the laboratory desires to include a probability of p less than 0.05, or in other words, 95% of values within the expected limits, we'll use a z-score of 1.65. The laboratory determines from their LIS that the CV percent for the test is 3.2%. Lastly, we'll use the calculated bias from our previous example, -4.8%, as the bias for the test. We'll multiply the z-score, 1.65, by the CV percent, 3.2%, and then add the bias, 4.8%, resulting in a TE of 10.1%. Now that we've determined that the TE for the test is 10.1%, how do we conclude if this is an acceptable amount of error? This is done by comparing this result to what's the allowed amount of error for the test. That is, total allowable error, TEA. Let's review what we've learned about total error, TE. Total error is the overall error in a single test result due to imprecision and bias of the measurement system. The formula for calculating TE is z-score times imprecision percent plus bias percent. The z-score is the desired probability of inclusion inside the target limits. The imprecision of a test can be obtained from calculation CV percent equals SD divided by mean times 100. LIS, third-party QC software, interlaboratory reports, external quality assessment scheme. The formula for calculating bias is lab mean minus consensus group mean divided by consensus group mean times 100. The lab mean can be obtained from LIS, third-party QC software. The consensus group mean can be obtained from interlaboratory reports, external quality assessment scheme. For all of your laboratory QC needs, go to www.qcnet.com.